five world gymnasts who suffered from worst injuries. Gymnastics is such a complicated and demanding sport that gymnasts must consistently prepare for the rigorous physical and emotional grinds that go with it. As the routines get more complex, the risk of potential injury increases. Each year, more than 86,000 gymnastics-related injuries are treated, and some of the worst accidents in history are truly heartbreaking. Number 1. Adriana Duffy-Orling. Adriana Duffy-Orling can impress anyone with her credentials. A graduate of Yale Law School and Stanford University, a former litigator in a big San Francisco law firm, a Santa Clara University School of Law faculty, among many others. It shouldn't be forgotten that Adriana was also the 1987 Puerto Rico national champion and most outstanding gymnast. But it was that athletic career that brought her an unforgettable nightmare too. In October of 1989, Adriana was in the thick of practicing for the World Gymnastics Championship in Stuttgart, Germany. The maneuver she was practicing was a routine one, featuring a handspring and a front somersault. To everyone's horror, her hand slipped, causing her to fall badly and dislocate her neck. At the age of 17, Adriana became a quadriplegic, paralyzing four of her limbs. But her courage and resilience made her rise above the adversities. 4 months after successful surgery, Adriana attended her classes at Stanford using a motorized wheelchair and advocated for disabled students. From there, she went on with her life and fulfilled more lofty dreams. Number 2. Wang Yan. For a 15-year-old athlete who's just starting to fulfill her dreams, the devastating news of possible lifetime paralysis is the worst physical, mental, and emotional torture she will ever endure. And Chinese gymnast Wang Yan endured such, but triumphantly overcame it. On June 10, 2007, Yan hoped to showcase her best at the national championships in Shanghai, China. Instead, the worst happened. She accidentally fell from the uneven parallel bars, landed on the mat head first, and fractured and dislocated her second and third vertebrae. The horrific accident put the young gymnast in a coma, and her condition was compared with top marrow damage, which results in death in 98.5% of cases. But a week after her surgery, Yan improved beyond her medical team's expectations. She was able to relieve herself on her own, swing her left arm, and lift her legs up and down. 2 years later, Yan managed to walk slowly as she recovered faster by the day, thanks to intensive rehab. Her miraculous survival is indeed her greatest victory, more than all the medals in the world. Number 3. Samir Otsed. French gymnast Samir Otsed may have fulfilled a longtime wish of representing his country in the 2016 Rio Olympics, but his cherished dream of winning a medal was crushed due to a severe leg injury. In the qualification phase of the men's artistic gymnastics on August 6, 2016, Samir landed badly on the vault, causing his left leg to snap with a sharp crack heard throughout the arena. As he rolled over while clutching his leg just below the knee, his foot and lower part of his shin dangled in the opposite part. Samir writhed in pain but managed to raise one arm as acknowledgement to the ovation of the crowd. The serious injury resulted in a double tibia and fibula fracture, which required an immediate operation. Despite the mishap, the athlete's spirit wasn't shattered. On the Olympic Facebook page, Samir was quoted the day after his operation, "Believe me, the Tokyo 2020 adventure is still on the cards. We'll go for that gold." Number 4. Sang Lan. Chinese gymnast Sang Lan never represented her nation in the Olympics, but she had the rare privilege of being the ambassador and relay torchbearer in the successful 2008 Beijing Games. She could have brought pride to China in previous Olympic editions, but a 1998 accident hindered the possibilities.
You were in the air. Did you know it was all wrong?
In the Goodwill Games in New York that year, 17-year-old Lan was doing a simple vault warm-up when she misjudged the timing of her landing and fell on her head. It seriously fractured Lan's two vertebrae and injured her spinal cord. She underwent spinal realignment and cervical spine fusion. However, the injury to the spinal cord was quite extensive, resulting in paralysis from the mid-chest down. It abruptly ended her gymnastics career, but opened new doors for Lan. Upon returning to China, Lan became a celebrity and an advocate for the disabled. A TV miniseries was produced about her life, She hosted her own TV show, studied at Peking University, and became a mom in 2014. Hopefully, these blessings are more than enough compensation for the misfortune Lan went through. Number 5. Julissa Deanne Gomez. Julissa Deanne Gomez got interested in gymnastics at the age of 3 by watching 5-time Olympic gold medalist Nadia Comaneci on TV. Gomez became part of the San Antonio, Texas Gymnastics Club at age 5 and was trained by renowned coach Bella Caroli at age 10. When she was 15 in 1987, Gomez was considered a legitimate contender for the 1988 U.S. Olympic team. But several months before the 1988 Olympics, Gomez's gymnastics career ended and shattered, too, her dream of becoming America's Comaneci due to a terrible vaulting accident. In May 1988, Gomez was competing in the World Sports Fair in Tokyo, Japan. While warming up for the May 5th finals, she raced towards the Yurchenko vault, but her foot slipped off the springboard, causing her to slam headfirst into the vaulting horse. The high-speed impact instantly paralyzed Gomez from the neck down. At a Japanese hospital, her ventilator was accidentally disconnected, which led to severe brain damage and coma. Gomez succumbed to infection and died in 1991. Her tragedy prompted changes in gymnastics to ensure the athlete's safety, and that became Gomez's legacy. If you find this video infotaining, please subscribe to our channel and make us part of your daily habit.